Hi everyone, welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and this is our day 10 of 5 minutes vocabulary. So far we have done the 9 videos, and you can watch all the videos available on the YouTube channel of BankExamsToday. And if you're liking all these videos and you wish to see more of the videos, please like our channel, like our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel and share it with your friends and family. That encourages us to work hard and hard and hard. So without wasting any another minute, let's start with the very first word, that is beguile. Beguile is charming. You see a very beautiful girl in a wedding, okay? So how do you feel? You are totally charmed by her, like wow, she's so beautiful, right? You see a beautiful dress at a store and then, oh my god, what a dress it is. So that is charming. Beguile is a verb which means to attract, and sometimes it is used in a negative manner, which means we are trying to charm people in a deceptive manner. We are using fake appearances to charm or enchant someone, okay? Like this person is trying to attract all these ladies towards himself, okay? Maybe he's trying to be deceptive, okay? So beguile is a verb. Synonyms are charm, attract, captivate, bewitch. Bewitch is a negative word. It means to attract someone towards you using false appearances. Dazzle, spellbind and hypnotize. Antonyms are repel, turn off. Turn off means you're not interested at all. Disgust, you start disliking that person, or resist. Example, she beguiled the voters with her good looks. Okay, she beguiled the voters. It means she tried to bewitch the voters using her appearance. Voters need a candidate which is strong and have abilities, but instead of showing her abilities, she took help of the looks, and voters were all attracted towards her. The next word is ostentatious. Ostentatious, which means that is extremely showy, or you are trying to display the things to impress people. Okay, so let me give you an example. There is a friend of yours who bought a new car, okay, car like this, and he is on a ride. He comes to your house and shows you the new car. What is being ostentatious? Ostentatious means you are being very pretentious. Okay, look at my new car. Oh my god, this is so expensive. I bought it for like 10 million. Okay, so when someone is showing or pretending that he or she has a lot of money to impress you, that is being ostentatious. And the synonyms are showy. Means the person is trying to be showy, like I have this, I have that. Flamboyant, gaudy, garish, vulgar is another word for ostentatious. Sometimes people try to dress vulgar in order to attract people or attract attention. Extravagant and fancy. Antonym should be calm. Ostentatious means that is extremely loud or not at all modest. So opposite will be calm, modest, plain, reserved or moderate. Example, we have my wealthy aunt who enjoys flaunting her wealth always. Okay, the lady loves to flaunt her wealth or money she has. Wears an ostentatious diamond necklace. Ostentatious, that shines from a very distance, that you know that she is wearing the diamond necklace. Why is she wearing the diamond necklace? To attract people or to tell people that yes, I do have money. Okay, then the third word is immerse. Immerse means to dip. Immerse is a verb. Basically immerse is used when you're totally involved in something. Like if I'm teaching, I'm totally involved in teaching. If you are studying, you are dipped, you are extremely involved in your studies or whatever you are doing. Okay, so immerse means to involve deeply in a particular activity. Okay, so it also means to submerge in a liquid, like this is a glass of water and we dip a tea bag in it. So it is immersion. Okay, to dip something is to immerse. So when you see the word immerse, just look at the cup and there is a tea bag. Tea bag goes into the cup and it is totally involved in the water. It's trying to leave the colors or the taste in the water. So immersing means you are trying to involve yourself in something and not bothering about anything else. So synonyms are absorb, engross, occupy, engage, involve and engulf. Antonyms should be dehydrate. It is from the dip. Dip means you are dipping in some liquid. Dehydrate means you are extracting the liquid substance. Then we have dry, ascend. Immerse means to go down. Ascend means to go up. Increase, rise, disinvolve, ignore and neglect. Example is, to keep her mind off her divorce, Jill will immerse herself in work. It means he will try to involve him in the work to keep her mind off the divorce, to distract the mind. Fourth word is aloofness. Aloofness means someone who likes to be alone and distanced from everybody or society. Okay, like this child is not involved in any play or any sports. He likes to stay distant from everybody, from kids, from family members, from society, anything. So aloofness is a state of being distanced, remote or withdrawn. You don't like to socialize with people. This is called aloofness. Synonyms are detached, because you are not attached to anything. Distance, unbending and unclubbable, means you don't like to club with people. Antonym should be companionable. It means a person like to accompany other people. Convivial means friendly, extroverted. Example, her cool aloofness was seen as arrogance by some people. Aloofness means he likes to be distanced from people, but people think that he is being arrogant. The last word today we have is ephemeral. Ephemeral means something that is very short-lived. Something does not have a very long life, like this ice. When you keep ice in the normal temperature, it starts melting. So it lasts for a very short time. So that is called ephemeral. So the synonyms are transitory. It means it is not going to last very long. Short-lived, momentary and brief. Antonyms are enduring. It means it will endure the temperature and will keep on staying in its particular position. Lasting, permanent, perpetual is another word for permanent. Eternal. Eternal means that never ends. Everlasting. Example is, some relationships are brittle and some are ephemeral. It means some are short-lived. Okay, so this is all about today's video. You can download the PDF in the description board. Okay, and if you have any doubt, you can drop your emails at raman@bankexamstoday.com, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing and work hard.